Friday, lots of good energy. Hi everyone.
Hello.
I am hoping you are doing fine. We are into week three of quarantine. And we're doing it. We're doing it. You can sample fitness buffets all day long. I've already had one full body workout this morning with Berries of Canada, so that's fun. And today, I'm going to do a kettlebell workout with you. So hopefully you have a kettlebell ready. And while we're just getting everybody settled in this morning on both Facebook and Instagram, coming to you live, it's Tosca Reno. I am the founder of the Eat Clean Diet, but mostly my passion is your wellness. So here's a little homework for me. Those of you who've been following along, you know what to do. Tell me where you're listening from. Tell me what's going on with you. Tell me with a thumbs up if you can hear the sound okay. Let's see. Good morning from Tennessee. Hey, hey. Hi, Tracy. I know who you are. Yeah, and I've got someone from Holland, it looks like. Yeah, tell me what country. Let's see what this global family looks like. So awesome to be here with you. All right, so we are going to get started. I'd love for you to let's get going with a little bit of a warm-up while we're all settling in. Necessary weight. Use a light one if you need to. I'm just going to start light. It's not about ego, it's about getting it right. So, athletic stance, and we're going to basically pass the kettlebell side to side, hot potato, hot potato, hot potato. So, what we're doing, I'm just going to chat with you while I'm doing this. What we're doing is keeping that core tight. Little move. We're gonna hold the bell by the corners, okay? A little heavier. Yes. Are you stabilizing that core? Send me a hashtag replay. Send me what you like about this. Send me if this is your first ever kettlebell workout. It might be. It might be. I'm going super easy, guys. I'm not going to work you too hard. Corn on everything. All right, a couple more here. A couple more. Here we go. One more and last one. Like that. And let's just swing side to side. Swing it, transfer, swing it, transfer, swing it, transfer. Always moving, always hot, always muscles burning. Yes, and yes, and yes. And the next move is the football pass. I think you're gonna like the football pass. The great thing about the football pass is you need to get a lot of mobility in your torso here. Bell is going to be here at chest height. And basically, it's going to be like catch the football and bring it down. And catch the football and bring it down. So you're twisting, catching. This way, catching. And the idea is to go over your shoulder, get that torsion, put that flexion in your torso. Okay. So here we go. We're going to go for 10 good reps either side. Are we ready? So, kettlebell in front, start to the right, ready? And reach, and catch, and reach, catch, reach, catch, reach, catch, twist, good, twist, good. Keep that flexion in the waist, really twist, absolutely. Engaging and fire, engage and fire. You've got the ball, don't drop it. On the ball. Yeah. All right. Good stuff. Can you feel all those muscles warming up, picking out? Maybe parts of you are cracking right now. I don't know. I can hear things in my shoulders. Couple more. One. Two. Two more. Fantastic. Good. That was quite the noise, wasn't it? Yep. Okay. Let's go got it now. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Now that bell has energy, so be very careful not to stop it quickly, otherwise you're gonna hurt yourself. You gotta go the other direction, right? So let's go the other direction. And again, swing one. One, two. Good job, everybody. Three. Be ready with your hands. Dropping it almost. Five. Hands open. Six. You're gonna be stronger on one side than the other. You'll notice that. But your coordination builds. It's great to build these patterns. It's great for your brain to keep active. And it's great for you to keep those fingers, your hands, your wrists, everything rotating, moving, warm, blood flowing. Maybe we're spending so much time at home. We're just gonna keep doing this until I stop talking. Maybe you're spending so much time at home that you're on your butt and really not moving much of anything. So, all right, let's let that kettlebell stop. Come to a slow down. Good job, everyone. Take a little sip if you need to. Step touch, step touch, step touch. Okay, while we're here, again, not using an ego weight. If you don't have a kettlebell, don't worry. You could use maybe a heavy water bottle, a can of beans, a small child, a rock. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a press. So it basically looks like this. For women, you're going to bring the kettlebell up beside your chest. We can say breast, right? That's my breast. Okay, so up, and then a little squat, press. Now, the press is not done until your ear touches your bicep. Bring it down, squat, press. Got it? So it's a little squat, press. A little squat, press. Come with me now, come with me now, we're doing 10. Good, start with the right. Good, get that ear to the bicep. That's three, I'm sweating already, how about you? Four, use your core, five. Six, straight up over, seven, hold that bell tight, nine, and last one. Bring it down, rack it, and now we're gonna do the other side. Good job, move slowly. You don't have to wing that ball around too, bell around too hard. Now you may find when you go to the other side that there's gonna be one side of you stronger than the other. This is my weak side, so I'm gonna have to work on it and I'm gonna have to fight myself, because I want to be able to complete the 10 reps, but I don't want to hurt myself. So, little squat and press. Nice. Good job. Right up to the ear. Remember, that's a complete rep. That's three. Good. Four. And a squat is five. A squat is the butt is back, like that, right? And the hips come forward. So, lots of squatting action for you. Good. Five more. One. Good. Two. And up. Three. I actually like this. Four. And five. Good job. Rack it and bring it down. All your movements with the kettlebell need to be slow and deliberate so that you're not going to throw the bell away or drop it or not lay your teeth out. Okay. So, get the bell by the horns. Again, not using an ego weight because we're gonna do some triceps now. So here's what's gonna happen. We're gonna hold the bell by the horns. This is called the bell and this is called the horns. So hold it by the horns and now we're gonna do triceps here. Elbows close to the head. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, come on with me now. Nine, didn't think I was gonna do this alone. 10, 10 more. One, elbows tight. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Now take it forward slowly, slowly, slowly. And from here, we're gonna get in a squat. Now we're gonna do curls. One, two. So I'll show you what that looks like. Three, four, 6, 7, squat as low as you can, 9, and 10. Leave it here, leave it here, leave it here. Up over the head, triceps, elbows close. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. You know what's coming. Squat low, squat low. And here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, low, low, low. 5 more. 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, hold the dumbbell up, hold the kettlebell up. Pulse me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Well done. Beautiful, beautiful. Okay. Step it out. A little sip of water, not too much, not too much. Step it out, just swing. We're gonna move into lunging side. So a lateral lunge with a touchdown. All these football terms, not really a touchdown though. So what that's going to look like is holding your kettlebell in your right hand, planting your right foot, all right? A little off-center grip, so you're not holding it right in the middle, you're holding it a bit off-center. You're going to lunge to the left, touchdown. Lunge to the left, touchdown. Lunge to the left, touchdown. Lunge to the right, touchdown. Get as low as you can. I have to keep myself within the frame of the Instagram frame. Okay, here we go. Let's do this. 10 good ones. That's one. Feel it inside here, your inner thighs, your outer thighs. And get nice and low, back flat, eyes up, switching hands as you go. Kettlebell touchdown. Here we go. Push, push, push with those feet. Push. Good. Pushing up into that upward stance. Love it. Back flat. Don't forget, use your core. All your power comes from your core. That's where it comes from. Excellent. Four more. Good job, good job. Nice. Can't low touch that kettlebell. Right to the ground. Love it. Love it. By the way, Colin has a nice discount for you. I'm going to set that up. And if you want to order some dumbbells or some kettlebells, my goodness, he'll take good care of you. Apparently, kettlebells are flying off the racks for home gyms. Isn't that crazy? Okay. Whew, good job. You feel the heart rate getting up. If you ever are in a moment during your workout where you feel like you need to pay back a bit of oxygen debt, which is what happens when we're breathing hard, you can do the Qigong move where you're actually touching here on your belly and on your adrenals and then alternating. So Qigong, and you're basically awakening your dragon chi, your energy, lighting yourself on fire, lifting your sacral heat, your root energy. Very, very good, very good. Okay, now we're gonna work on something fun. I love this. This is agility, coordination, concentration. It's a lot of good things. For right now, the bell that I've been using is a 6 kg. It's about 13 pounds. The next size up for that is 8 kg, 17 pounds. For you, for the purposes of this, I'm just going to keep it light so that you can see the movements clearly and we learn the form. So, feet are, you're going to get into an athletic stance. Your feet are hip width, they're greater than hip width apart, actually. And once again, you're holding an off-center grip. And what we're going to do is start the kettlebell swing. So, you want to swing forward, behind, so you can grab that bell. Watch what I'm doing. So, low, low. Low, flow, good grace. Low, flow. Push it back. Push it back. Bring it forward. Push it back. Bring it forward. Push it back. Good. All right, and pretty soon, you keep your eyes up. You just go with the flow. All right, here we go. 1, I like this so much. 2, come on. 3, 4, push it way forward, way back. 5, 6, heart rate's coming up. 8, 9, I feel so fluid when I do this. And 10, now, let it slow down. Opposite direction, right? So we're gonna go the opposite way. So behind and forward, behind and forward. Stay low, see? I did it again. Let me start again, here we go. 1, even I drop the bells. I gotta pay attention. 2, 3, good. Swing and swing. Hold, focus, focus. I'm gripping harder now because I shouldn't really be dropping that bell at all. And here we go, last 5. 1, 2, 3. And get that momentum, my 4 and 5. All right, let it swing. Now, we're gonna do this again, figure 8s. We're gonna go 4 one way, 4 the other way. I will call it out. Hold on to the bell, clearly. So hold on to the bell. All right, here we go. Starting clockwise first and around behind. That's 1. That's 2. Good. That's 3. And that's 4. If you forgot which way you're going, whatever you're doing, go in the opposite direction now. That's 1. That's 2. 2. Come on. 3. And 4. Good. Good job. Good job. All right. That's called figure 8. Really love that. I don't know about you, but I'm sweating. Let's do a little check-in on everybody. A little sip of water if you need it. How are we doing? How are we feeling? Loving it. Nova Scotia, the deck. I've been there. Lisa, Maria, Karen Ann. Hey, hello, Teresa. Good job, everybody. Still a little too loud. Okay, is music better, I hope? Music is good, okay. I'm hearing without a problem. All right, wonderful. So what we're gonna do now is we're going to lunge with the kettlebell and pass the bell. So this is all about coordination, good lunge form. I'm gonna cheat myself to the camera this way so that you can see what I'm doing. So it's going to be a lunge forward, pass the bell. Up, lunge forward with the other leg, pass the bell. Are you with me? So a lunge, pass under the leg. Pass under the lunging leg. Pass under the lunging leg, good. It's alternating legs. Keep your head up. It's not this, it's not that. Okay, it's this. Lunge up, beautiful. And let's get this going. That's 1. That's 2, good. That's 3, isn't this fun? Look at the boring old lunges. That's 4. Going for 10. Come on, you got this. That's 5. And then I'm going to have protein pancakes afterwards or overnight oats because I made them yesterday. Yeah. Good job. Legs are getting tired. Keep going, though. Where the pain is where the growth is. All right. Last 2. Good job. Good job. Here we go. Last 1. Good. Good. Way to go for sticking it out. Good job. Those lunges feel so different when, whew, here you go with the oxygen deficit. All right, little swing, little swing. We're gonna get to the swings in a minute. We're gonna do rows. The legs are tired, the heart rate is up, it's a good time to do rows. I'm gonna go with a little heavier weight on a row. So I'd like you to lunge forward, it's like warrior position basically from yoga, lunge forward with the left. Your back leg is in a T position. If you're gonna rest your arm, rest it mid-thigh on that beefy, meaty, fantastic, strong quadricep. Don't rest it on your knee. You can shift your patella out of the said position. Now, grab your kettlebell, and we're in a lunge position. We're gonna row. 1, 2, head up, back flat. 4, come with me now. 10 good breaths. 1, 2, good job. Is your tummy flat? I think so, right? Keep it tight. That's 5. Halfway. Come on. 1, 2. Good job. 3, 4, 5. Now stay here, stay here, stay here. Head up, back flat, tummy flat. Everything engaged. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10 more. faster. Two, three, four, five, six, tummy, eight, nine, 10. Step out and reverse. We've got two sides, we've got to take care of both of them, right? Movement is medicine. Once you brought this down, you're gonna feel fantastic. Anybody else sweating? I hope so. Remember, if you're resting, your forearm on your leg, put it way up here on the nice knee part of your quads, not your knee. All right, deadlift, back flat, head up, core engaged. One, two, good job. Three, I like that you're keeping your head up, focused on what you're doing, and your tummy flat. Fantastic, good job. Four more, three more, and I also like that you're keeping elbow nice and tight to your body. Trying to get that this part of your arm level with your back, parallel with your back. Nice, okay, hold me right here. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, sweat in my eyes, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now give me some faster reps here. 10, 1, 2, 3, good job. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. Put your kettlebell down for a second. Step touch me out, step touch me out. Let's do a little time check. Let's do a time check. See how you're doing. I'm so completely sweating, it's running into my eyes. Oh, we have a few more minutes. Awesome. We're gonna finish off with kettlebell swings. Whew. Okay, so I had a nice little lesson with Colin Lake from Great Lakes Girya. Thank you, Colin. We had a great session because kettlebells are new to me, but I absolutely love them. Place your kettlebell in front of you so that when you reach forward, I'll bring one a little closer, to pick up the bell for the swing, you're not overextending yourself. The key piece about the swing is that it's not a squat when you've got the bell in your hand. It's a hinge and an explosion. Hinge, explosion. So your hips are going back and then exploding the weight forward. This is harder to do with a light weight, so if you have a heavier kettlebell, use it. So we're gonna come forward, back flat, hands up, your butt is right out back behind you, and your knees are bent in a squat, you're just soft knees. Now you're gonna grab that kettlebell, and you're gonna bring it, and you're gonna swing it. And it's like, three, four, and explode, explode. And that's a contraction that's happening right off of your upper thigh. Come on, we're gonna do 10. And that's 10, 9, 8, check your form, 7, 6, 5, 4, explode, 3, 2, 1, okay, swing and park. That's how you safely park your bell. How did that feel to you? Is that good? Listen, that kettlebell swing is like the mother of all moves. If you can manage to do a couple of good 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 20 minutes of kettlebell swings, you can hear the heart rate, the sweat, but we're not done. We're gonna finish. We're gonna finish with another, let's go for 12, maybe 15. So feet are wide and hip width apart, butt is back. It's this, it's this. It's not squatting like this, it's this. Okay? So, all right, you're gonna grab your bell, you're gonna let it come forward and explode. Two, three, four, pop that. Five, just explode it. See from the back. Two, three, four, five more. Two, yes, three, pop it, four, five, come on, five more, it's Friday. One, two, three, four, and five, woo, and bracket. How's that feel? Awesome, awesome. Okay, good. All right, last move of the day, bonus move. We're some catapult sit-ups. So that's easy. You get to go down on the ground. Your heart rate's still up, but that's good. That's a good thing. Okay, so on the ground, and your feet are flexed. I'll get myself in a good position for the camera. Feet are flexed. You've got the kettlebell in your hands. You're holding it by the bell. Two hands. Thumbs looping around the base of the horn. So you're going to go down. You're going to do an overhead stretch with the kettlebell. Up. Down. Overhead stretch. Reach out as far as you can behind you. Up. Get right up on those. And down with control. Down with control. And up. Pop, up, up. That's three. Come on. We're going to do 10 together. That's it. That's it. I promise. All right, here we go. Here we go. Come on, let's get some energy. One. Two. Beautiful. Three. Woo! I'm feeling it. Four. I'm just so sweaty. And five. I love this. Come on, come on. These last five ones, that's where it all is. Right here. Four. Three. And two, last one. You got this. Woo! Put your kettlebell down. Listen, you guys are amazing. It's Friday. Just take a few deep breaths. I'm gonna take a little bit too much of your time here, I think, but come with me now with a little bit of a stretch. Let's just let our hearts come back to a regular beat. Oh yeah. Open up those shoulders. We worked them hard. We worked everything. Listen, this is working with kettlebells for me seems to be torching all kinds of crazy stuff in the middle of my abs. Oh, I'm much sure on my left. Oh, why is that always the way? But it is. It's just how we are. It's the way we're wired. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Stretch up. Hands up. Open up those shoulders a little bit. Ribs, lungs. So glad you joined me. I'm really so glad you joined me. Waking up on Friday, where we don't even really know what day it is anymore. What's your plans for the rest of the day? Tell me more. Go ahead and stretch your arms out behind like that. Show off your triceps. Just kidding. All right, bring your arms right across in front of you. I love you so much. I really do. You know, I've been finding that the more time I spend with you in front of the camera, as I have been over these last couple of weeks, I'm learning more about what you need, what you want, how your heart moves, what's going on, how I can serve you better. I'm super stoked about that. Okay, hands to the side. For Instagram, I don't think you can quite see, but basically I'm just turning my fingers down and up, which is a great bicep stretch. Great bicep stretch, right? I encourage you to go ahead with your stretching to open up the rest of your muscles today. If you've been taking advantage of a lot of workouts, which are available just like I've been here during this quarantine time, take an Epsom salts bath today. Put a few drops of lavender oil in, but Epsom salts is critical. You can certainly loosen up your muscles and encourage recovery. Also, after a workout like this, you're going to want to have a good protein-based breakfast. So what would that look like? A smoothie that has greens, fruits, vegetables, fats, but not too much fruit. Okay, here's what I say to you. Just pile in the hearts. Share this with someone you love. Share this with somebody who needs to work out a little bit or do it again sometime. Be happy. We're going to post all of this on IGTV and Facebook. Blast me with love. Let's raise the vibrational energy. Tomorrow I'm doing another journaling session. Surprisingly, that went so very well. So join me for that. Don't worry, the schedule is on toscareno.com. Sending blessings for love, joy, happiness, and physicality today. Remember, my passion is your wellness. God bless. And Facebook just ending now. Thanks for the hearts. God bless. And for some reason, it does not want to end. Come on. There we go.